Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah. Our moral value for today is integrity. Khuluq al-wafa. In the dictionary, integer means whole, complete, consistency. In Arabic, al-wafa means ikmal, to complete, itmam, and iltizam. So the two words have the same meaning, integrity, al-wafa. Al-wafa, khuluq al-wafa, is one of sifat Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَمَنْ أَوْفَى بِعَهْدِهِ مِنَ اللَّهِ. It is one of shu'ab al-iman. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, لَا إِيمَانَ لِمَنْ لَا أَمَانَةَ لَهِ وَلَا دِينَ لِمَنْ لَا عَهْدَ لَهِ. Which means, if you are not trustworthy, you are not a mu'min, and if you do not fulfill your promise, you have no deen of Islam. We know that ad-deen al-mu'amala, that the essence of our deen is the treatment among each other fairly and kindly and nicely. The Prophet, in the Quran we read, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِأَمَانَاتِهِمْ وَعَهْدِهِمْ رَاعُونَ. Those who fulfill or honor their trust and their covenants and treaties. Integrity or khuluq al-wafa, it is connected with doing good, not the evil thing. So you do not fulfill your promise in doing something bad. And it is across the board. You do it to every human being. You have to have this khuluq. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought our attention in Surah Al-A'raf after mentioning the stories of many, many of the civilization and how they were destroyed. We read in Surah Al-A'raf, تِلْكَ الْقُرَى نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ مِنْ أَنْبَائِهَا. He's telling us about the stories of this civilization. Then he gives us Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala diagnoses what was their problem, what was the common denominator among all these destroyed civilization. In the following ayah, he says, فَمَا وَجَدْنَا لِأَكْثَرِهِمْ مِنْ عَهْدٍ وَإِنْ وَجَدْنَا أَكْثَرَهُمْ لَفَاسِقِينَ. So خلق الوفاء, to fulfill your promise, to honor your word, to honor your whatever agreement, contract, treaty, is very essential in Islam. And al-wafa with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to fulfill your position as his servant and slave and obey all the commandments. We call it covenant, mithaq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran told us, alam a'had ilaykum ya bani adam. And in another ayah, وَأَوْفُوا بِعَهْدِي أُوفِ بِعَهْدِكُمْ. الْوَفَاء بِالْعُقُود, عَقْد means contract. So you have to fulfill and honor your part of it. It's an order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَوْفُوا بِالْعُقُود. Fulfill your contract or honor your contract. الْوَفَاء بِالْعُهُود, مُعَاهَدَ means treaty. وَأَوْفُوا بِالْعَهْدِ إِنَّ الْعَهْدَ كَانَ مَسْئُولًا. الوفاء بالوعود, whatever promise you give, you have to honor it and fulfill it, because the hypocrite, and by the way, the opposite of integrity is hypocrisy. And the opposite of الوفاء is also نفاق, hypocrisy. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam described the hypocrite, saying, "Al-munafiqu idha wa'ada akhlaf." The characteristic of the hypocrite, whenever he gives a promise, he will break his promise. "Wa idha ahada ghadar," and he betrays the trust. الوفاء بالبيعة. Whenever you sign a covenant with whatever entity, like governments, like your citizenship, you have to honor the law of the land and whatever you are supposed to do, like taxes, and you do not cheat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَوْفُوا بِعَهْدِ اللَّهِ إِذَا عَاهَدْتُمْ. Al-wafa in the marriage, we call it a vow, or also we call it a covenant, very special contract. It's protected by the divine. وَأَخَذْنَا مِنْكُمْ مِيثَاقًا غَلِيظًا. To honor this is very important, especially to pay the wife her dowry. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam told us, إِنَّ أَحَقَّ مَا وَفَّيْتُمْ مِنَ الشُّرُوطِ مَا اسْتَحْلَلْتُمْ بِهِ الْفُرُوجِ. That means on the top of the list, things you need to honor and fulfill is that contract of marriage with your wife. Al-wafa bid-dayn, when you borrowed money from somebody, you have to be keen on returning the money and fulfill your promise to him, because it is something very big not to pay the money. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us, the martyr who spilled his blood, sacrificed everything for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's forgiven of all his sins except ad-dayn, the debt. So he has to pay the debt. To start with, never put yourself under debt if you can. Al-wafa bil-kayl, with all the dealing and wheeling and measurements, you have to be honest and to fulfill your obligation. وَأَوْفُوا الْكَيْلَ إِذَا كِلْتُمْ وَزِنُوا بِالْقِسْطَاسِ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. So it's very important and very essential to fulfill your duty in buying and selling. الْوَفَاء بِالنُّذُرِ, when you vow to do something like fasting a month, if you pass the exam, or if your wife deliver a healthy baby, you want to give money to fulfill your promise and your vow, because most of us, we forget about it. Whenever we're safe, we forget what we have vowed. And one of the important things, which we also rarely we do, al-wafa bi-jamil. Anyone who does good to you, pay back by thank you, by appreciation, by blessing him. Jazakallahu khayran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran told us, هَلْ جَزَاءُ الْإِحْسَانِ إِلَّا الْإِحْسَانِ. So when you don't do that, this is breaking the wafa. And also Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, if you don't thank the people who were the tool or the way for doing something, you are not thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَنْ لَمْ يَشْكُرِ النَّاسِ لَمْ يَشْكُرِ اللَّهِ. So this is al-wafa bil-jameel. Al-wafa bil-kalima, you have to honor your word. Whatever you tell somebody, you have to do it. One time a mother told her baby to come over. She has some sweet in her hand, and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked her, "Show me, do you have anything in your hand?" She said, "Yeah, I have a date." Or so he told her, if you did not, you broke your promise with him, your trust. So you have to be, even to animals. You remember the story of Imam Bukhari, who made a 1,000-mile trip to pick up a hadith from somebody in Baghdad, and he found that person cheating his horse, telling him to come, showing him that he has some food in his lap, and he hadn't any food. So Imam Bukhari made a U-turn and went back home, because if he lied at the animal, he can lie to anyone else. So Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam warned us also, the hypocrite, three characteristics of the hypocrite. إِذَا حَدَّثَ كَذَبْ, when he talk, he lies. وَإِذَا وَعَدَ أَخْلَفْ, when he promise, he break his promise. وَإِذَا تُمِنَ خَان, when he is trusted, he betray his trust. And last, الْوَفَاء بِالْمَوَاعِيدِ, you have to honor your appointments. And you have to honor your promise to your friend when you want to meet him somewhere. You have to be punctual. This is a characteristic of our deen, punctuality. We see it in the salah. We're punctual to the last second. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his khuluq was al-wafa all across the board. You go to the seerah, every page has story about wafa. But I will tell you 10 second, one story before he became a prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He agreed with a man to meet somewhere, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was on time. He was punctual. And he waited there, and the man did not show up. There was some transaction. He wanted to give him money. And the man did not show up. 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours. Then the man remembered when? After 3 days. And he knows who is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whose name was As-Sadiq al-Amin. And after 3 days, he went to the spot where he agreed to meet him, and he found Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam standing there waiting for him. And he didn't become angry. Where have you been? I've been 3 days waiting. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was worried about that man's safety. He first thing, he checked him out. Are you okay? What happened? You know, he told him, for God. The name of that person was Abdullah ibn Abi al-Hamsa. So dear brothers, it's very important chip on our motherboard of our brain, al-wafa. This has been eaten up very badly. It's rusty. We need to replace it, put a new one, and fulfill our promises, honor our words, and be punctual. Make it a habit. No excuses. May Allah bless you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.